which member of the bus control which segment. Okay, this is a standard. This is the only way to do it. You don't have another way to do it. So let's go back in here. So 777 display has a orientation or configuration like this. Okay. Industry standard A, B, C, D, E, F, G, D, P. Okay. A, B, Z, D, P. This is the industry standard. Everybody addressed it this way. However, if you look at a bus, we don't have bit A, bit B, C, D. We have numbers. Okay? So, in the code, we have, this is member 7, I'm sorry, member 6, member 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, and this one is 7 is not changing because we don't need to deal with the decimal point. Okay? Are we clear? So you don't have to deal with number 7 at all because it's a constant. It's always either high or low. You'll figure out high or low. Okay? You need to figure out how to manipulate the inputs through your logics and create the corresponding highs and lows to drive the LEDs accordingly. Okay. Right? And the input will be a bus. Any question about the STD logic vector? In digital electronics, part 2, you probably need something similar or what? But you use schematics. Block diagram. We're not doing that. Okay. You still need to understand how the logic works, but you're writing the equations without going through a block diagram. Okay. All right. Even though the equation is this long, it's okay. Just type. The tool doesn't care how long the equation is, as long as it's correct. All right. Any questions? So this is a hexadecimal to 77 display. Understand? Sorry. Go through the truth table, figure out the equations, and then write it. Any questions? When is this due?
Thursday.
Right. This Thursday. So once we finish this one, the next assignment will be different. And they're all different. The future assignments, you need to use these PDs. So make sure you get it done. Because I'm not giving you that PDs. Everything is built on top of each other. You have the first one, the second one, and the third one, just 6 of them in a row. Right? And things can get more complicated and more complicated. All right, any questions? Good, so now you can start. Make sure you use the STD logic vector. Okay. So, before we finish, let me just copy the code. So you have a... Okay, now please pick up your old assignment this summer. Okay. Yes, that's everything I have for today.